drivers behind the lines in 3, 2, 1, crescendo.
And it's showtime as robots from the Red Alliance already leaving their zone for the 2 points. We'll see if all of them can get it for the 6 points in auto, and they are attempting to score more into the red speaker. They may be in a feedback loop, and it looks like the robotic rams have a bit of a defensive robot, probably trying to block the notes from being scored into the speaker. We'll see if that will be effective as match 9 progresses. Now we're in the teleop period of the match. 296, the Northern Knights already scoring into their blue speaker. But as we thought, the robotic rams trying to block them with their high design. 7709, making the journey all the way to Tech Valley, acquiring a note around the center line, looking to score it into their red speaker, and they do just that. Score now 17-11 with a minute 30 to go. We have a battle around the middle line between 229 and 3181. It looks like 3181 is trying to drag the notes over to their red speaker so they could be scored by other shooting Alliance members. 7709 electing to take advantage of that strategy. Right now, it seems Division by Zero is the most mobile robot on the Blue Alliance, but they have a note stuck under their chassis. It's being destroyed, but maybe it could still be shot in. But why do that when there's so many other ones in their sources? .3181, Pittsford Panthers around the center line. Could they be playing for an early climb? Not too early, because there's 20 seconds left as we hear that guitar riff, 29-13. Still enough points where a lot of stage robots could make a difference. And it seems they got a successful climb on center stage, high notes flying everywhere. We'll see if anything gets spot lit. No other robots were able to get on stage off the ground. But some Parkmans taking the victory, 36-15.